In the opera of the universe, the overture was delivered with pomp, thought, and splendor. The overture was a big bang. And in the aftermath of this cosmic explosion, planet Earth was forged out of some of the ensuing shrapnel. Superficially, this rocky planet may have looked undramatic, but do not be fooled by the cool facade. Underneath this rocky shell is a nucleus melting furnace that constantly hammers and batters the Earth's surface into shape. Equally ferocious and relentless was the ruthless force of natural selection. Nature, red in tooth and claw, had no place for the weak. There was but one rule, survival for the fittest. And the rule was observed by all. After billions of years of evolution, we came along to do what we do best. Mimicry. On canvas and in machine, we try to emulate nature, to capture its very essence. And the closer we studied nature, the more we realized that nature itself operates just like a machine. Once we've gotten our heads around some of the rules that govern the workings of nature, we started a revolution that fueled the growth of human population like no other time in history. But we weren't the sole benefactors of this revolution. Some of our tinier friends were on it as well. With humans living more densely than ever, germs and bugs had but the perfect cohort of hosts in which they could grow and multiply. This, of course, was at all possible because all life speaks the same four-lettered language. The code of life is universal. And once again, if unknowingly this time, we caught up with nature. We too realized that it's all about the code, and that information is all that matters. This is our story, the story of who we are and of how we came to be. It's the story that we'll be telling in the Zewail Science Festival, the greatest story of all time.